It's always good to hear good news. Yeah. We hear so much bad news. We're always hearing about people who's ill. I think we're going to change it around one day and come in and tell you who's well.
Yeah.
But good news. It's always good to share good news. And she's just come through. Holly's just come through a massive operation. It wasn't just a normal operation. It was massive. So we've been praying for her. And now we just feel that our prayers have been answered. So it's good news that Maureen can come and actually share with us. Let's begin our service by singing together. Number 20. Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. Stand to sing again, number 319, Christ Triumphant, Ever Reign.
Corinthians, As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," the Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but only one thing is needed. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." Thanks for it.
Thank you. We stand to sing again, number 362. 362, Meekness and Majesty, Manhood and Death. Because if not, he was not a very good host, and people would not return again. So Martha was actually doing a good role. There was nothing wrong with the role. And Mary, When you think of Mary, what she did, she sat at Jesus' feet and listened to what he was saying. And there's nothing wrong with that. And in some senses, on another occasion, Jesus might have said something different. But on this occasion, there was something special. And that was, Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem, to the cross. And you've got to start asking the question, what is more important at this present time? What is more important at this present time? Now, my daughter, who's, let's just say over 35, because I can't remember. She's always reminding me of when she was at school. I don't know how old she was. She was of an age, and it must have been about 8:45 in the morning, it wasn't school day, and she fell down the stairs. And she was yelling and screaming and crying, and she said, "My arm hurts, my arm hurts." And then we decided we'd have to take her to the hospital. But I said, "I need to go up and have a shower first." And I did. I went up to have a shower because I said, "It's only bruised, don't worry. I've got time for a shower. I'll nip up, have a shower, I'll get myself ready, and I'll get you down to the hospital." I get her down to the hospital, and two hours later, she's coming out with a cast. She's broken her arm. And she said to me, she said, "Dad, why did you have to have a shower before you would actually do take me to the hospital?" And in a way, it's a little bit like this. It's what is most important at the time. And even now, she reminds me. She even tells me that she's still got a bump there. She blames this bump on me now, where the bones heal. But we often think of things in our lives. When we've actually put something which is least important in the way of doing something important. If you think about it, this might be you, might not be. Imagine you've got someone coming, right? It could be someone who you haven't seen for years. They could be coming from another country. Say they're coming from Australia. They're only here for a couple of weeks and then they're going back. The likelihood you're not going to meet again, right? And then while they're there, the first thing you do is try to get the house up to the condition that you think they want it to be in. Am I right? So that's the first thing. What a waste of time sometimes. You could be doing something better. But anyway, and then one of the persons there, instead of sitting down and talking with them and being with them, you feel you've got to be busy. You've got to be doing something. And actually, you can miss the moment. You can miss that moment. I'm sure there's times in our lives when we think to ourselves, it could be with our parents or something, you wish you'd spent more time with them because you didn't know what was around the corner. And I think we've all been in that place. I'm not accusing anyone because I think we've all been there. Then all of a sudden something may happen and you don't get that opportunity again. I had to write the article for the Jigsaw magazine this week, and I used it on, we went to our granddaughter's sports day. And I remember going to our children's sports day. And I always remember thinking, and it was a little bit like this passage, if I don't go and watch them and experience them and support them, I'm going to regret that for the rest of my life. And in fact, they might bring that up with a broken arm. But I think we've all been in that situation. So I'm not pointing the finger at anyone, but I think sometimes we can point the finger at ourselves and say sometimes there's things that's more important. And in this passage, with Jesus making his way to Jerusalem, making his way to the cross, Jesus will not be with them much longer in person. You've got to make the most of every minute in his presence. And I believe that's right. For that occasion, we should all become Marys. There will be times when we've got to become Marthas, actually become doers. Sometimes we've got to be both. But this passage, I think it relates to us more than we ever think. Because every day is special. I think someone once said it's a little bit like toothpaste and time. You can spend a lot of time like squirting toothpaste out, actually doing not a lot. But when you try putting it back in the bottle, it won't go. It won't go back in the tube. Especially if you've got a pump action. Cool, that's good, isn't it? You can't put time back. Time has so much time in a day. And we need to use it and ask ourselves, what is the most important thing to do at this present time? I believe that the Bible speaks to us. I think it speaks to us as powerful now as it did all those years ago when it was written. This isn't just about Mary and Martha and Jesus. This is also about us. Our relationships with our families, with the church, and with our Lord. We give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us now just pause a minute. Let's just bow our heads and think about our lives. And maybe how we need to change. And think of those things that are more important. Maybe it doesn't always matter if the house is a little bit untidy. If there's more important things we have to do. Heavenly Father, we're all guilty sometimes. Not doing the right important thing at the right time. Maybe there are times we should have acted in different ways, or did different things, or to spend time with people that we love. Lord, as we think of Mary at your feet, it was a special time, and a time that Mary will never have again. And so, Lord, help us to build up those special memories that we can keep in our hearts for those that we love, but especially for our love for you. And Lord, as we think of the journey he was on to the cross, as we now move into a time of communion, we again remember that you gave of yourself so that we may be set free, that our faith will bring us eternal life. And so, Lord, we give thanks for this passage and what it teaches us. In Jesus' name. Amen. Communion hymn number 348. He is Lord, he is Lord. He is risen from the dead, and he is Lord.
He is Lord.
And so now as we come to the bread and the wine, we remember on the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. Eat this, because it represents my body to be broken for you." And then as supper was ended, he took the cup for the final blessing. And he said, "This wine represents my blood to be shed for you. Take it and drink it in remembrance of me." And we're instructed to do this until he comes again. Chose the final hymn, I didn't know the weather was going to be like this. But we will dance in our hearts. Number 247, I danced in the morning when the world was begun. Next step.
Bye.
And now, Lord, as we leave this field, send us out with the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and with the love of God and in the fellowship of the power of the Holy Spirit. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.